about your professionalism, man. And because I know you kicking that ism, and sometimes people forget the person. You know what I mean?
Yeah, man. My mama told me a person that's late all the time. She say, for one, that's a character defect. That's a character flaw. Right. A person that can't be on time, man. So I respect time, because I know at the end of the day, that's all we got is time.
Right. No, you're absolutely right, man. So how you was down there for All-Star Weekend, man. You hung out with Let's Go Champ, man.
Yeah, man. That's my day. My people called it a bro man. So they say me and the nigga got a bro man. But nah, man, good dude, man. We kicked it the whole weekend.
Oh man, yeah, that's what's up, man. So you're a boxing fan?
Yeah, man. You know, Ali, Sugar Ray Leonard, man, Mike Tyson. Evander Holyfield, Shannon Briggs, Lennox Lewis, Money Mayweather. So yeah, man. I'm into it.
You didn't say Deontay Wilder, man.
No, I don't like Deontay Wilder.
Oh, why? Why you don't like D?
Yeah, he let that white boy whoop him. Yeah. He talked all that shit about he fighting. Talking about our people been fighting for 400 years, and I'm fighting for my people, and get in there, nigga, and let that white boy do him how that white boy done it. I'm mad the motherfucker.
How you think he gonna do in a rematch?
He go, that white boy go whoop him again.
You think so? You don't think
I think he just big and ugly. I think he just big and ugly.
Oh, you said Wilder.
I think Deontay Wilder just big and ugly. He really can't whoop no. Yeah. He ain't no bad motherfucking boxer. He ain't no Ali. He ain't really that ferocious.
So you discount those 41 knockouts in a row and all that?
He ain't really whoop nobody.
Okay.
And you know, that's easy for me to say as a little bitty nigga, 5'9", you know, 127, 28 pounds. But I don't think he ain't it, my nigga. We done seen a lot of great heavyweight champions throughout our lifetime, from 1977 when I was born to now. And he don't sit with the greats.
Okay. Well, we're going to talk about that. I think D going to get him, man. I believe in D. I think he's going to catch him. But you got a boy down there, Earl Spence Jr., man.
Yeah. Earl Spence is a drunk. He's a recovering drunk. You know, I used to see him in the club drunk all the time, man. Hold on. I'm trying to fix this light. So that used to leave a bad taste in my mouth, right? So. Somebody's always watching.
Right.
So he didn't realize people were watching. So, you know, locally, man, you know, he would get plastered in the club, would have to be carried out club sometime. I seen him, you know, with the angry drunk wanting to fight at the club once before, man. So it turned me off to him. I'm a character guy, right? Whether you're a boxing champ or a Super Bowl quarterback. Character, homie. Somebody's watching. And so when he had that wreck, I understood that, you know, that's one of those crossroads in life that God kind of tug at you and let you know, hey, you know, get it together, man. So I'm anxious to see his comeback. But I don't think he's the same man.
He just had a win. I'm not sure if you followed. He just beat Danny Garcia. Did you catch that?
Yeah, I checked it out. Danny Garcia don't hit hard enough. I think the nigga was rushed back. The type of wreck that he had, we watched him get thrown from a vehicle. The vehicle, that was a horrible wreck, homie. So, you know, I think he was rushed back too soon. Mm-hmm. Danny Garcia ain't no power donkey kick punching kind of nigga. So he ain't got no power punches that'll break his jaw. He ain't got no power punches that'll, you know, loosen up them teeth that he had to get fixed. Put him in there with that boy Crawford. And put him in there with Crawford and see if that chin is battle tested.
Who you like in that fight, Spencer Crawford?
I'm going with Crawford.
Really?
I'm going with the nigga that's the underdog, man. He the underdog.
Uh-huh.
And you know, the one that's eating at the top of the hill and his hungry is the one trying to eat common at hill, man. So I'm going with that underdog, man. Crawford.
I think. The funny thing is, I think I think the other way about Crawford. I don't think Crawford's that good. I don't think his quality of opponents is that good. You know, because if you're giving Danny Garcia some slack, I don't think Crawford has the best resume.
I can't argue with you. I ain't gonna say he ain't battle tested neither. Uh-huh. So very seldom do we ever see two Vipers get in the pit.
Right.
So let's let them two Vipers get in the pit and make.